Indus civilization, a very ancient Bronze Age urban civilization which once flourished in the northwestern part of Indian subcontinent. In this video, we're going to look into a brief introduction of Indus civilization. In the year 1826, a British East India Company soldier, explorer and traveler, Charles Masson, came across some mysterious brick mounds near Harappa. Harappa is now located in Pakistan. Charles Masson thought that they looked like some old castles, and he identified this place as an ancient city called Sangala, the capital city of Porus, belonging to the time of Alexander. He mentioned about this in his book Narrative of Various Journeys in Balochistan, Afghanistan and the Punjab in the year 1842. Around 1853-54, Alexander Cunningham, a British Army engineer and an archaeologist, visited these ruins at Harappa and noted that there were uniformly laid brick walls in this area. Alexander Cunningham did not pay much attention because he was more interested in exploring Buddhist sites or Buddhist monasteries. In 1856, British officials in India began the construction of a railway line connecting the cities of Lahore and Karachi. And as the labourers continued with their works, some of the labourers discovered many, many fire-baked bricks. They used some of them to construct roadbed. Obviously, they were not aware that they were using some ancient artifacts. There were many bricks, uniformly laid and quite old. They soon found among these bricks some stone artifacts made of soapstone featuring intricate artistic markings on them. That's when they realized that they were not dealing with some bricks buried under the earth, but they were looking at something more than that. In the year 1861, Archaeological Survey of India was formed with Alexander Cunningham as the first archaeological surveyor appointed by Lord Canning. Now, if you remember, after the Great Revolt of 1857, East India Company got dissolved and Crown Rule was established in India, and as a part of the Crown Rule, Viceroys were sent to India. Lord Canning was the first Viceroy to be appointed in the year 1858. In 1861, Alexander Cunningham was appointed as the first archaeological surveyor, but this position was suspended from 1865 to 71 due to lack of funds. In 1871, Archaeological Survey of India was revived as a separate department by the then Viceroy Lord Lawrence, and Alexander Cunningham was appointed as its first Director General. After getting appointed as the first Director General, Alexander Cunningham revisited this site at Harappa in around 1872-73, and he noted that many number of bricks were taken away from this site and many of the ancient structures at the site were damaged. He noted that the number of bricks taken from the ancient site was enough to lay bricks for about 100 miles of railway line between Lahore to Multan. He mistakenly concluded that this site was a Buddhist monastery, and he also came across some seals and believed these seals to be of some foreign origin because these seals depicted a bull without a hump. So Alexander Cunningham thought that this cannot be of any Indian origin. In 1886, M.L. Dames published a report on the seals of Harappa, and in 1912, John Faithful Fleet published a report about findings from Harappa and its surroundings in the Journal of Royal Asiatic Society. So, though archaeologists know about this site Harappa since 1826, nothing conclusive was done about it. In the year 1902, Sir John Marshall was appointed as the third Director General of Archaeological Survey of India by the then Viceroy Lord Curzon. Sir John Marshall allowed Indians to participate in excavations in their own country. What followed is by 1920-22, two ancient sites were discovered. Around 1920-21, under the leadership of Rai Bahadur Dayaram Sahni, Harappa was excavated, and by 1922, Rakhaldas Banerjee discovered Mohenjo-daro. These two sites, Harappa and Mohenjo-daro, left the historians of the world surprised because what they found was not a mere archaeological excavation, but it was a proof to the world that there existed a very ancient, fully grown, highly advanced urban civilization which flourished in the northwestern part of Indian subcontinent. In 1924, Sir John Marshall announced to the world the discovery of the oldest civilization in Indian subcontinent. This is named as Indus Valley Civilization because the sites found, Harappa and Mohenjo-daro, were located near Indus River. But as more and more sites started getting discovered far from actual river Indus Valley, this civilization is later named as Indus Civilization. Usually, a culture is named after the site from where it is known for the first time. Since it was at Harappa that the relics of this civilization were first noticed, this civilization is also called as the Harappan Civilization. Nearly two-thirds of the archaeological sites discovered so far lie on the dried up banks of Ghaggar River. Ghaggar River today is a monsoon-fed river, but the Paleo-Ghaggar, that is a river which might have flowed some thousands of years back, was a perennial river which flowed into Arabian Sea. Some historians believe that this Paleo-Ghaggar River is nothing but Saraswati River, or it could have been a tributary to Saraswati River. So some historians prefer to give this civilization the nomenclature of Indus Saraswati Civilization, and some scholars even prefer to call this as Saraswati Civilization. Many sites have been discovered so far, but important one among all these sites is Mehergarh, which is located in Balochistan. Between the years 1973 to 1980, two French archaeologists, Jean-Francois Jarich and Richard H. Meadow, conducted some extensive excavation works at Mehergarh, which is now located in Balochistan. This site, Mehergarh, gave the world the earliest and most comprehensive evidence about domestication of animals like sheep or goat and cultivation of food like wheat and barley. That is, it showed the first combined evidence of its kind in the world. So Mehergarh is very important when we study about Indus Valley Civilization. We shall look at what was discovered in Mehergarh and what are the phases of the discoveries from Mehergarh in very much detail in another video. Let's now look at the extent of this civilization. This civilization is largest among the four ancient urban civilizations, which covers an area of about 13 lakh square kilometers, which is much greater than either Mesopotamian or Egyptian civilizations. The westernmost site discovered so far is Sutka Gendor, which is located on the banks of the river Dasht in Pakistan. The easternmost site discovered so far is Alamgirpur, which is located on the banks of Hindon River. Alamgirpur is located near Meerut, Uttar Pradesh. Northernmost site discovered so far is Manda of Akhnoor district in Jammu and Kashmir. This is located on the right bank of Chenab River, and the southernmost site discovered so far is Daimabad in Maharashtra. Daimabad is located on the left bank of Pravara River. Pravara River is a tributary to Godavari River. The east to west distance is about 1600 kilometers, and the north to south distance is about 1400 kilometers discovered so far. Recent excavations in Rajasthan revealed a 4000 year old village settlement at a village named Balathal. This is located near Udaipur. So from the artifacts found so far, there were strong affinities between Harappan and Balathal settlements. So from the active radiocarbon 14 dating process, the oldest known agricultural settlement in Indian subcontinent is Mehergarh, while the oldest known village settlement in India is Balathal. This Balathal is outside the Indus River zone. Let's look at the chronology. The entire timeline of evolution or development of this Harappan phase can be divided into three phases: the early Harappan, mature Harappan, and the later Harappan. Early Harappan is from 3300 to 2600 BC, and then there's a transitional phase from early Harappan to mature Harappan, and mature Harappan phase from 2600 to 1800 BC, and late Harappan or later Harappan period is from 1800 or 1500 to 1300 BC.